Okay, now we're going to do Squeeze Box by The Who. Cool song, very un-Who-like. three chords for the most part, and lots of little variations. I'll teach you the right way and the campfire way. Campfire way meaning, as always, the way it will sound best when it's just you and nobody else playing. Okay, and there's some banjo parts in here, and I'll show you how to kind of emulate those, and so on. So this song is primarily only three chords, your G chord, which I always like you to make a four-finger chord by adding your pinky at the third fret on your high E string and right above it with your ring finger here on the B string. Okay, so then you get a full instead of your normal. It just does not sound good. You'll find that most of the pros out there working instead of the bedroom players will actually use the full G chord this way. Makes for real nice easy things, especially like in this song where we'll be going from G to this kind of a C where you just drop these two fingers down. Okay, otherwise you'd have to be going and it just is not the way it's done. Okay, so for every one of my lessons, unless I tell you different, please always do a four-finger G chord. So G, D, and C are the main chords here. If you listen to the beginning, which is this, okay, that is actually going back and forth between what's the regular G, then what's called a D suspended 4, or D add 4, or just D4. Which means you play your D chord, but we have to play it differently and get rid of the note that's on the G string, that A note. We're just going to play it like this. So your first finger, second fret, first string, and then your middle finger on the third fret of your B string. And use your thumb to dampen your low E and your A. So you're going to try to play only the D strings on down. So you got G. Going back and forth, and you want to keep those two open strings, okay, your D string and your G string, ringing as much as humanly possible. So strum down, then that, okay, use this to shut up those two bottom strings. Why it sounds so weird is because you have the open G string, but you're trying to make it sound like it's basically just doing this, going, and then actually going back to that type of thing. So that's what we're emulating. It just goes back and forth and does that. So that is exactly what I showed you we were going to be doing, is going back and forth instead of G to C, G, C, G, C, G, C, like you would. Just do this. Okay, it's just going from a G chord with the added fifth, is actually what that's called if you ever need to know, the D note. Now, it sounds better if we do it as a campfire thing, as opposed to the way that it's really played. They really don't do it that much in here. They do it with the vocals, but it just really lends itself to the campfire version, if you will do that. As much as possible when nothing else is going on. It just fills up the song, and people think they hear it. They actually don't hear it because it's not there a lot of the time. But it sounds really great for the campfire version to just drop those two fingers back and forth. So your rhythm hand. Okay, so let's pick it up from the beginning, which is. Then. forward if you need to come in. There's a quick little thing that Pete does there. Open D string, hammer on to the second fret, and then G note. You'll hear it right there before they come in. Right there it was. I'll play it one more time. Okay. So right before it comes in singing, you'll hear that. So it's just... Okay, so it's just a quick little trill, is what it's called, T-R-I-L-L. Okay, so while we're playing the verses, I'll just kind of yell out the chords and show you some little tricks that come in. So again, G, D, and C are going to be our things. When we're doing D, there will be a lot of suspended fourths, or D add four, so you add your pinky to the third fret of the high E string. You'll hear that a ton in this song. So when I say D4, that's what we're doing. And when you're in C, it's doing the same thing, but you have to flatten out your first finger. So C, and cover the first string at the first fret. That's kind of a tricky one, but it's all over the place, kiddies. So let's get right into the song where the vocals come in. Okay, we're going to our G. Rhythm is straight. Root note. The root down up, up down up. Root down up. Up, down, up. That's your stroking pattern. One more time. Stroking pattern. Strumming pattern. Root, down, up, down, up. Okay? So we keep moving. That's what we do here. Keep moving. Now D. Okay, so we did a quick D4. Playing all night. The music's all right. So you can add a quick four in there. Whenever I see a four, just go to of whichever one we're on. Okay, and you can put these in wherever you want. It's yours. You don't, we're not here to play it exactly right. We're here to play it however it gets us by the best when we're a solo performer. Okay. To C. D again. C. Now G. Okay, now there, they are not doing the... Now you can choose whether to do that or not. Okay, one person's just back here. This is Pete doing everything. And one time he's just going from the second fret to the third fret on the low E string. Or you can do... And all that stuff is, the other ones that I'm showing you, you're just doing open D string, hammer on, and then you can do the G's again. It's just like the pickup note that we did right at the beginning, right before we started singing. But you can't just keep doing that by yourself because you have no band to back you up, so you better fill it in with the rest of the notes that are available, which are pretty much... all of them below the D string. So you can actually do the hammer on, then up on all the strings that are left. If you get that note out of there in time, you can actually pick up four strings. And we're mixing together. So whatever you want to do, those are all your choices, because all those are going on sometime throughout the song. Okay, keep picking it up. I'll let you listen to that part. There's a little tiny lick in there that goes like that, which is open D string twice, then again with the hammer on, then the G string, then hammer on open D to the second fret, and then the same thing, but hammer on then pull off on the A string second fret, then the G. See? Throwing into if you want that little lick. Check it out. There it was. Then the okay, so you can toss it in if you want. Okay, from here on out, we are just cruising through this, okay? Come back in with the second verse. G. To D. Four, C with the fourth, D, C, and G, C, G. Here's a solo part. Now that part there was not much of a solo part, it just hangs there on the G. You can toss something interesting in there if you want. That's all I'm going to say about that. I'll say one thing, there is twice, three times in here, this. That happens in here. Third string, sliding from the third fret up to the fourth. Then you put your first finger down on the third fret, B string. So if you think you can get that in and make it sound good, all the more power to you, but that is played in there a lot. So if you can get it in there and make it sound good without it going too dead sounding by eliminating your rhythm, like I said, more power to you. We'll back up right before that, and here we go. Stays there on G. Now D with the four. C with the four. D back to C and G. I like to do this. G. Same thing. Okay, so I did the same thing as we did before. You heard it there. Check it out. Same lick. Now we don't just have to hold it, because there's like banjo slash mandolin being played there, maybe even played on guitar, but it's just going. Okay, this is called butterfly picking. Leg your pick kind of on its side, and rub up and back and forth as much as you can. Okay, so if you hit the first note, the first chord, come on and squeeze. Come on and squeeze me. Come on and feel me. And then C. Butterfly picking. And D. Okay, so we're going to have to do those. That's as good as I can explain it to you in this amount of time. Here we go. Butterfly picking time. And after this, G, butterfly picking, big chord, butterfly picking, D chord, butterfly picking, C, butterfly picking, Tickle, tickle, D, and C, and G. Here's this lead solo. Whatever you want to play. D. D, C, and G. Now all that, do whatever you want. During those chords, it is being played on a banjo. You can be going, pulling off from the suspended fourth. Okay, so you're in D. The C. You can do the... It's hard to make something happen, so you might want to do open G. Okay, so you're playing kind of your C chord. Take your finger down to the G string, open G. Hammer it on the second fret, and then play your C note on your B string. So, back to D. Or you can do the... To do the C part is cool too. Same thing you did on the D. And then just move the whole thing backward, but then you just run out of room, which is fine. And then just do your pinky thing. Lambic. Okay, so whatever it takes to get through the solo. But you have to play it while playing chords. Okay, so use your own discretion. It's very easy to get through those chords. Or just keep singing. Don't matter. Here we go. G. D. C. D. C. G. Right here, I like to go. She goes. How I like to get her done. Okay, let's check that out and play along with me. Do it if you want, only if you want. Here we go. And to the D. Add the four. C. Fourth. D. C. And G. The one time at the end when it actually does go. That's the end of the song, so it does go again. So down, up, down on the C chord. Down, up, down. Down, down. Down, up, down. Down. Okay, last time. Okay, so that's the whole song. Okay, that's everything. If you need anything, rewind. Okay, that's why these songs are fit into as short a span as they are. They need to be done fast, done quickly. Anything that you might have missed, again, rewind. I'm just going to turn up the volume, and we're going to play along. That's all the instruction you get on the song, because that's all you need. Okay, so here we go, right from the beginning. Once again, the Who with Squeeze Box. I will be playing the chords on here, but doing a Milli Vanilli. I'll be doing a fake version of it, so you can jam along with this track and play it how you will. Oh, hey, they just ended the song. Go figure. Okay, so here we go from the beginning. Remember. Got that funky D thing at the beginning. Okay, here we go. So there you go. The Who's Squeeze Box. A lot of fun little things to add in there. The signature licks are there if you want to do them. If not, just play the chords and campfire the heck. Just, it's all about fun. Okay? So have fun with that one. Catch you on the next one.